I'm Ruben, and this is Tech Enthusiast.
Hey, welcome back to the channel. So I have owned the Samsung Z Fold 2 5G for going on 6 months. And these are my thoughts after 6 months of actually owning the device. And while I think, you know, initial impressions are cool and going over all the features when you first get the device are cool, you know, it's really important to, I think, do your more long-term reviews and figuring out, you know, how well the device holds up over time. And so, excuse me, the first thing you'll notice is I have a case on here, and the case just happens to be the Spigen Thin Fit case for the Z Fold 2. And I did a review on this case, which I think is a pretty good case, and so I'll link that in the description for the video. But this review, again, is not about the case, it is about the device itself. So I purchased this back in mid-August, and it is now the end of January. So it's going on about 6 months that I've had this device. And so the first thing I want to mention is this is definitely the kind of device that you want to put a case on. You know, it's surprisingly durable, considering all of the incredible technology that's crammed into this device, but at the same time, it is still an investment at $2,000. So it's something that you want to be mindful of. Now, with that being said, I want to talk very quickly about this case, the leather cover. Also did a review on that. I'll link it in the description. I switched from the leather cover to this one, because this only protects the back of the phone, and you definitely want to get a case that's going to protect the entire phone. So I want to compare a lot of this phone to the original Fold, which I had for actually about a month and a half when I decided to return it. And you've heard this from a lot of other reviews, is that the original Fold just felt like a very unfinished product. It felt like you were paying a premium price for something that was very unfinished. And this isn't the case with the Z Fold 2. It definitely feels like a much more refined product, to say the least. And I feel like after 6 months, roughly, of using it, that it's still an outstanding product to have. So even starting with the cover screen here, you know, on the original Fold, it was a very, very small screen, less than 5 inches big, this one being 6.3 inches corner to corner. But on the original Fold, it was considered to be a cover display, and it was almost like it was an afterthought. It was so small. It was virtually unusable, and it was almost the equivalent of like your caller ID screen on the outside of the phone. You couldn't use it for much, but when you wanted to really get anything done, you then had to kind of open up the screen. And that's not the case with this particular screen. It is a full functional screen. It functions and behaves and works surprisingly well. At 6.3 inches, it's so much more usable than the original screen. And you know what's really funny is on the original Fold, you could not even multitask on the original screen. So on a screen like this, multitasking isn't ideal because it's on the small side, but it's possible. On the original Fold, you couldn't even open up two apps on the same screen. It became unfortunate because you were only limited to one screen. So I think the fact that you can now open up just two apps on this main screen is outstanding. With that being said, there is a lot less bezel on this screen. You've got a Infinity O display, so your camera for the front is built in, at the top of the screen here, so it makes it much more usable by way of just putting a lot more information on the screen. One thing I will say about the Z Fold 2 is that when it comes to just the in-hand feel of this device, being able to hold on to it is outstandingly comfortable, because it is kind of, it almost reminds me of a TV remote. It's just, it's very thin. And so unlike a lot of wider phones on the market, you're able to hold it in your hand relatively easy, and it just creates a better feeling of security for something that's going to run you $2,000. So no real complaints about the screen. The screen on the outside does have a standard refresh rate of 60 hertz. So, you know, if anything that you feel like is going to, you know, that you want to experience in a high refresh rate, you're not going to be doing it on the outer screen. But all in all, the fact that it's much bigger, the fact that they've upgraded it to an Infinity O display, the fact that you are now able to multitask from the outside screen is definitely a big win. So, you know, you've got, of course, your bottom firing speaker here, your top firing speaker here, and so it means that you've got some great Dolby Atmos sound on this particular device. Very, very, very loud device as it relates to your speakers. Now, what's interesting is you do not get 45 watt fast charging on the Z Fold 2. Although it is, you know, a premium device, the latest and greatest, it tops out at your 25 watt fast charging. So just something to be mindful of. Along the side, you've got your fingerprint reader here. You've got your volume rocker. You've got a microphone up top, and you've got a microphone along the bottom, along with your charging port. Excuse me. So no real complaints about the cover screen. Once you get into your inner screen, that's when kind of the real fun begins. The idea that you can have a phone that changes into a tablet, or a tablet that folds into a phone, it is a really, really cool idea. And with the second generation, because it's been so refined, it doesn't feel like a concept anymore. And, you know, they've integrated your ultra-thin glass. It doesn't feel any different. This is still a very soft and flexible inner display. I imagine with the ultra-thin glass that's layers down behind this, you know, it's going to add a little more strength and durability. But overall, it still feels the same. You're definitely going to want to baby this inner screen, because while the outside might be Gorilla Glass, this is still going to be prone to damage from, you know, fingernails, styluses, any kind of sharp object. So you definitely want to be careful about that, of course. Now, this screen in here is a high refresh rate screen of 120 hertz. So on the original device, you know, we're talking about the original Fold, you know, there was an issue where if you were scrolling on one side of the screen, the other side of the screen simply just couldn't keep up. And so they've all but eliminated that issue with the high refresh rate screen. It means that viewing movies or playing games or doing anything, because it is dynamic, meaning it's going to change your refresh rate, I think, from anywhere between 10 all the way up to 120 hertz, it's pretty impressive. So it's very energy efficient. Overall, the inner screen is outstanding. Now, one thing I will say is that after about 2 weeks in, I ended up taking off the screen protector on the screen, both on the inside screen and the outside screen. Now, for the inside screen, actually using the flex mode, which essentially just means leaving the phone in this kind of orientation too much, is what caused a number of bubbles to appear in the middle of the screen here. So I ended up pulling the screen protector off of the inner screen, but I haven't looked back since. I actually feel like it was a good decision. It's much less fingerprints that show up on this screen than ever did on the screen protector on the original. So I wouldn't suggest removing it, but unfortunately, if you get a lot of those bubbles that appear under the screen, you may have no choice but to remove it. But if you do, I think you'll be pleasantly surprised with the feel of the screen underneath your screen protector. So overall, the fact that this uses an Infinity O display as well, which means you have a lot less bezel than the original Fold, and you just have a single camera here, it creates a much bigger and more pleasant screen to look at and to work with. And so overall, you really can't beat it. It's comfortable to use. It's just the perfect size, I think, as it relates to having a phone that, again, folds into a tablet. Infinity O on the outside, Infinity O on the inside. I find this phone to be very durable. You know, I'm not saying take it to the beach. I'm not saying, you know, use it without a case. But I'm simply saying that if you are someone who is generally pretty careful with your devices, then you will be fine with the Z Fold 2, assuming you get a decent case on it. If you're someone that's a little rougher, you like to throw your phones around, or you work in an environment that's going to create a lot of moisture or dust, this may not be the phone for you. One thing you want to be mindful of is it does not have any kind of IP rating. But I really don't think that is an issue or a problem. For me personally, again, after using it for 6 months, I've been able to use it without being especially careful with it, or babying it. I have been especially careful with it because I want my devices to last. I want this to last as well. So with that being said, you don't have to baby it, but you do want to be careful with it. Now, moving to the back of the device, this does support reverse wireless charging, and it does support fast wireless charging as well. You've got a triple camera here. It is 12 megapixels all the way around, and you've got your flash here, of course. Now, let's talk about picture quality very quickly. Are you going to get Note 20 Ultra picture quality? I would say no. I had the Note 20 Ultra. I used it to take some incredible photos. This comes pretty close, but it's simply not going to be the exact same quality as a 108 megapixel camera on the Note 20 Ultra. It has all the other bells and whistles. You know, it has the portrait mode. It has the night mode. So it does take some very good pictures. It simply can't match the 108 megapixel resolution on the Note 20 Ultra, but it gets very, very close. So please don't be discouraged about purchasing this device based on, you know, the number of megapixels. Now, the one thing that really needs to be mentioned about this Z Fold 2 is the hinge. You know, on the original phone, the hinge, in my opinion, was simply meant to connect, you know, one side of the device to the other side of the device. In this refinement, the hinge is actually extremely functional. The hinge is now been designed so that instead of just opening and closing the device, you actually have a device where you are able to put this in a number of different angles as you are using it. And it ultimately just makes the device much, much more functional. It makes it so that this is a device that you can use in a number of different ways. Whether it's standing up just to take a photo, whether you are trying to multitask by using, you know, the inside camera here in order to make a duo call, it creates much, much more functionality when it comes to a hinge that is actually functional and useful, like on the Z Fold 2. Overall, after 6 months, do I think this is worth $2,000? Honestly, I believe it is. When you consider the functionality of it, and I'm not going into a whole lot of the software features in this review, I'm speaking primarily about, just the overall build quality, the functionality, the usability each day. When you can easily go from using this as a phone to suddenly using it as a tablet for things that you need to get done, when you can easily go back to using it in phone mode. It just has incredible features and a lot of functionality. Great speakers, great microphone. You've got an outstanding processor with an 865 plus. You have 12 gigs of RAM. You have 256 gigs of onboard storage. It does not come with SD card support, so you cannot expand that. But if you are someone who streams a lot, if you are someone who keeps things maybe in your Google Drive or your OneDrive or your Dropbox or anything like that, you're not gonna miss not having a SD card support on this device. I use this for just about everything, and I have not come close to filling up 256 gigs. So it's plenty of space, in my opinion. I really don't have much negative things to say about this particular device. I find it to be functional. I find it to be useful. I use this as my daily driver. I think that the fingerprint is reliable. The fingerprint reader, excuse me, is reliable. I think once you put a good case on here, like this particular case that I have, and again, I'll link the video for this case in the description for this video. I think once you put a good case on this device, you really don't have anything to worry about. In a later review, I think we'll go more in depth into the software side and where they really improved the software in ways where it is better made to take advantage of the hinge that supports this flex mode. So that's something to be mindful of and to look out for. Overall, is $2,000 a lot to spend on a phone? It is. I won't deny that. But I think if you're going to spend that kind of money, and a lot of phones, whether they're Android devices or iOS devices, they're coming close to that $2,000 mark, especially if you consider you're topping out, with memory and space and that sort of thing. If you're going to come close to it, a few hundred dollars is going to separate you from the most expensive iPhone and this device. You might as well get something that is not only extremely functional, you're going to get something that's just unique. You're going to get something that you can put into tablet mode, into phone mode. You're going to get something that you can easily put a number of different devices on the same screen. Overall, it is a good device. Your inside screen is large with a very high refresh rate. Your outside screen is large and usable and functional. There are days where I can go all day, and if I don't need the larger screen, I'm easily able to use the inside screen, or I'm sorry, the outside screen, and not feel like with the original Fold that I ended up taking back after about 30 days that it wasn't refined. This feels refined, plain and simple. You can use this outside screen very easily and you won't feel like anything is missing. But when you really need to get something done and you really need to move into a larger space to get it done, then that's when this inside screen really comes in handy. So those are just some of my thoughts after using this device for 6 months. I paid for it with my own money. I think it's a great device. I think Samsung is just one of those companies out there that's really, really pushing the envelope on what we think a phone should look like. how a phone should be designed, what a phone can do. I feel like they've done an outstanding job with the Z Fold 2. The hinge is strong. It's very durable. The inside screen is very nicely done, and there's not a whole lot of bezels around it, which is great. A little bit more bezels on the outside screen, but not a big deal. And again, when it comes to these cameras, they're going to give you great photos. They're going to give you outstanding photos. So any questions or comments whatsoever, please leave a comment. I really hope that you have enjoyed this video. In the next one, we'll talk more about the software. Thank you for watching.
Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please press the like button. Please consider subscribing to this channel. And from one tech enthusiast to another, God bless.